我以主耶稣的爱来爱你，我以主耶稣的爱来爱你，在你身上可见王的荣耀，我以主耶稣的爱来爱你。And I love you with the love of the Lord. Yes, I love you with the love of the Lord. I can see in you the glory of my King. Yes, I love you with the love of the Lord. Let's sing that in Chinese again. 我以主耶稣的爱来爱你，我以主耶稣的爱来爱你，在你身上可见王的荣耀，我以主耶稣的爱来爱你。弟兄姐妹们，我以主耶稣的爱爱大家。
Yes, Lord, brothers and sisters, I love you with the love of the Lord.
呀，真现在如果你是跟家人在一起看这视频的话，就转向他们，跟他讲说我爱你。
So if you're watching this video with your family members, turn to them and say, I love you in the love,
yeah,
with the love of the Lord.
那另外呢，我们在散会之后呢，我也请大家打一个电话跟我们教会的弟兄姐妹说，我奉耶稣基督的名，或者说我以主耶稣的爱来爱你。
So after the service, I urge that everybody will pick up the phone and call one of the brothers and sisters of the church and tell them that, you know,I love you with the love of the Lord.
Yeah, 真的很想念大家。
I really miss you all.
那希望很快的能够见到你们。
How I hope that I'm going to meet all of you soon.
Yeah, 几天前呢，有一位姐妹跟我讲说，牧师你在荧幕上好看多了。
Yeah, a few days ago, a sister called me and said that, Pastor, on screen, you actually look so much better.
哎，你听好了呀，好看多了不是说好看呢。
He actually said, looking better, didn't say that I'm good looking.
好看多了意思呢，就是胖了一点点的意思啦。
When somebody say you're looking better, just means that probably I'm just a little bit fatter, plumber.
Yeah, 我希望能够很快的看到你们。
I really hope that I will meet you all very, very soon.
所以不单单只是要见到 Jackson, 我要见到 Doreen。
Not only do I just want to meet Jackson, but I also want to meet Doreen.
Yeah, 不单只是在跟 Brenda 一起做这样服侍的时候见到 Brenda, 我也要见到 Lester.
Not only do I want to, you know, meet Brenda when she's translating, but also to meet Lester.
还有呢，不单要见到 Wei Xu 呢，也要见到 Jana 跟 Jaylin.
Yeah, not only wanting to meet Wei Xu when she comes to help, but also want to meet Jana and Jaylin.
Yeah, 总之呢，真的是希望呢，快快的能够有机会见到你们了。
Well, whatever it is, I'm just hoping that we're going to meet each other very, very soon.
Yeah, 你们都知道，教会已经部分开门了。
We all know that the church is partially opened.
那我们现在呢，教会呢是开放给大家，能够在礼拜二跟礼拜六回到教会做一个个人默祷的时候。
So we all know that on Tuesdays and on Saturdays, the church is open for people who want to come to church to do a silent prayer, private prayer.
Yeah, 我们在这个个人的时间呢，也会播放一些的一个敬拜的歌曲，让大家能够沉浸在敬拜跟神的同在里面。
So when you're here in the sanctuary with your own private prayer, and we'll also be playing some worship songs so that you can actually immerse into the Spirit, the Holy Spirit that's around you.
Yeah, 讲真的，我们不晓得教会能够什么时候能才能够完全的开放了。
To be honest, I really don't know when will the church be fully open.
Yeah, 现在新加坡已经度过了这个阻断措施时期了。
Well, Singapore has just passed the circuit breaker period.
然后进入了我们所谓的第一阶段。
And now we have entered into the first phase of reopening.
Yeah, 所以这个第一个阶段呢，也是我们这个新常态的阶段了。
So this reopening of phase one is actually how we are entering into what we call a new normal.
Yeah, 在这个新常态当中呢，戴口罩是每一天必须要做的事。
So with this new normal, wearing a mask every day is something that's a routine for us.
然后呢，人与人之间要保持安全的距离。
And then between persons to persons, there's safe distancing.
乐龄人士呢，最好是不要常出门。
And the elderly are still encouraged not to leave the house so often.
就是避免人多的地方。
And to avoid crowded places.
然后排队的时候呢，还要保持距离。
And then when you're queuing up, there's also a safe distancing to maintain.
去到很多地方呢，我们都需要做这个 safe entry 的二维码。
So when we go to a certain place, we also have to enter with this safe entry QR code.
Yeah, 就是说呢，短时期内我们真的没办法恢复像过去的生活状态。
So in other words, you know, in this short time, we are unable to get into this normal things that we have been doing before.
好，所以这个所谓的新常态有什么特征呢？
So this is a new normal. What's the special features of this?
那我觉得这有两个很显著的特征。第一呢是保持距离。
I think there are two very distinct features. One is to continue this distancing.
然后第二呢是树立障碍。
And the second thing is to establish a barrier.
那所以全国其实全球各国呢的政府都在呼吁人民怎么做好准备，在这种新常态当中来生活。
So all over the world, their governments are telling their people how we must adapt to this new normal.
Yeah, 各国呢都是重新的在恢复社会啦、国家啦，还有经济的运作。
So all the countries are trying to return to the operations of their financial world, their economic world, and business world.
Yeah, 所以社会跟经济这些的层面呢，都是属于世俗的东西了。
So these social things and economic things are all secular things.
那是教会方面呢，属灵生命方面呢，是绝对不能够忽略的。
But the church, the spiritual living of a church cannot be neglected.
所以我们为什么呢？因为呢，属灵的生命呢是不只关乎到今生，而且关乎到永生。
Because the spiritual life is not only about our present days of life, but about our eternal life.
属灵的生命不只是关乎到肉身，而是关乎到灵与魂。
So the spiritual life is not talking about our physical body, but also about our spirit and our soul.
好，所以当全世界都在讲新常态的时候，
So when the whole world is talking about the new normal,
那我们要听一听神的国度，神永恒的国度所讲的是什么种新。
We have to think about what the kingdom of God is talking about, this new norm.
Yeah, 我们所讲的是一个又新又活的路。
We are talking about the new and living way.
是神的国度有一个又新又活的路。
It's true, the kingdom of God is about this new and living way.
这世界所讲的新常态是关注距离跟障碍。
The world talks about this new norm is about distancing and creating barriers.
这个又新又活的路所讲的是清净跟通道。
But our new and living way in our kingdom is about drawing closer and about channels, opening up channels.
Yeah, 所以你看那个对比，距离跟清净来对比。
You see the contrast about distancing and drawing close.
障碍跟通道来对比。
And then we compare barrier to channels.
好，我们一起来看神的话语。
Let's look at the word of God.
我们来读希伯来书第十章第十九到二十五节。
We want to look at Hebrews chapter 10 verses 19 to 25.
弟兄们，我们既因耶稣的血得以坦然进入至圣所，是借着他给我们开了一条又新又活的路，从幔子经过。这幔子就是他的身体。又有一位大祭司治理神的家， 并我们心中天良的亏欠已经洒去，身体用清水洗净了，就当存着诚心和充足的信心来到神面前，也要坚守我们所承认的指望，不致摇动，因为那应许我们的是信实的。又要彼此相顾，激发爱心，勉励行善。你们不可停止聚会，好像那些停止惯了的人，倒要彼此劝勉，既知道那日子临近，就更当如此。
So in Hebrews chapter 10 verse 19 to 25, Therefore, brothers and sisters, since we have confidence to enter the most holy place by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way opened for us through the curtain that is his body,And since we have a great priest over the house of God, let us draw near to God with a sincere heart and with the full assurance that faith brings, having our hearts sprinkled to cleanse us from a guilty conscience and having our body washed with pure water. Let us hold unswervingly to the hope we profess, for he who promised is faithful.And let us consider how we may spur one another on toward love and good deeds, not giving up meeting together, as some are in the habit of doing, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching.
我们一起来祷告。
Let us all pray.
天父上帝，我满心的感谢你。
Lord, we want to thank you.
因为你的话语是很宝贵的。
Because your word are so precious.
你的话语是我们脚前的灯，是路上的光。
Your word is a light to our path and a lamp to our feet.
今天我们要聆听你的话语。
Today we want to hear you.
主圣灵亲自来教导我们。
Holy Spirit, come teach us.
让我们心灵诚实的来领受你的话语。
Let us come forward to listen to your word.
使到主你的百姓、你的子民信心再次的提升。
May all these words raise the faith of all your people.
帮助我们定睛地仰望你。
Help us to fix our eyes upon you.
奉耶稣基督的名祷告。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. 第二十节呢，说到主耶稣他为我们开了一条又新又活的路。
In verse 20, it says, Jesus has opened a new and living way for us.
呀，这条又新又活的路呢，是因着耶稣的血而成就的。
This new and living way is possible because of Jesus' blood.
因为耶稣基督他流的宝血呢，是无瑕疵的献祭。
Because this blood that was shed from Jesus is one without any impurity.
那所以呢，就成就了一个使人能够跟神和好的壮举。
It's a sacrifice that's made so that we people, men, can draw near to God.
这条路叫做新路，也叫做活路。
This way is a new way as well as a living way.
那是新的，是因为呢是全新，是跟那旧的方式完全不一样的。
It is new because it's totally different from what was of the past.
活呢，是因为这条路呢是蛮有生命力。
Living because this path is full of life.
那是有创造力的。
It's filled with creativity.
并且是荣耀的。
And it's glorious.
那这条路呢，是使到人跟神能够不断的有生命的联系的。
This way allows men to be connected to God.
所以神所为我们预备的，他所为我们开的路呢，是一个叫做又新又活的路。
So this way that the God has opened for us is the new and living way.
第十九节呢，第二十节那边也讲到从幔子经过。
In verse 20, we also see that.Through the curtain.
那这个幔子这边所意味着的就是旧约的会幕或者圣殿的那个幔子。
This curtain is referring to what was in the Old Testament, which is the way through to the holy place.
Yeah, 所以在这个会幕或者圣殿当中，圣所跟至圣所之间呢是有一个幔子。
So between the holy place and the most holy place, there is a curtain.
那这个幔子呢是18米高，然后呢是 十公分厚的。
This curtain is 18 meters tall and 10 centimeters thick.
Yeah, 所以是一个很大很大块的一个幔子来的。
So it is a huge veil, huge curtain.
所以呢，这个至圣所，按我们所知道的呢，就圣经所告诉我们的，是大祭司一年一次在赎罪日才能够进去的。
So this most holy place, as according to the Bible, we know that only the high priest gets to go in there on the Day of Atonement.
但是圣经告诉我们，当耶稣基督他死在十字架的那一刻。
But Bible also tells us that the moment Jesus died on the cross.
在马太福音二十七章五十一节这里说，复然殿里的幔子从上到下裂为两半，地也震动。磐石也崩裂。
We can see that it is in chapter 27, Matthew chapter 27, verse 51, that at that moment the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. The earth shook and the rocks split.
是什么时候殿里的幔子裂开呢？
When did this curtain of the temple was torn?
那经文说，复然在那个时刻呢，就是耶稣他断气的时候。
The Bible says that at that moment, and the moment refers to the time when Jesus gave up his last breath.
那希伯来书十章二十节所讲的，他说这个幔子就是耶稣的身体。
So it is said that this in Hebrews that this is actually the curtain is the body of Jesus.
那因为耶稣基督的身体呢，就像那幔子一般的是为因为人的罪的关系的而被撕裂了。
So the body of Jesus was torn, broken.Because of the sin, for the sin of people.
所以这个幔子是从上裂开的。
So this curtain was torn from the top to the bottom.
这个是很重要的，因为如果是人撕开的话呢，是要从下面开始撕开的。
This is important point because when a man tears a curtain, they tear from the bottom.
但是圣经说这幔子呢是从上到下裂开的。
But the Bible says that this curtain was torn from the top.To the bottom.
还有注意，这个幔子呢，不是被卷上去的。
And note that this curtain isn't one that is just curled up and rolled up.
Yeah, 因为被卷上去的话呢，也就是说，可能有一个时候要放下来了。
So when the curtain is being rolled up, it can at any time be let down again.
圣经说这幔子呢是从上到下裂开，裂成两半的。
The Bible is clearly saying that this curtain was torn from top to bottom completely into two.
因为这个幔子已经裂开了，意味着人能够现在坦然的、自由的进入到至圣所。
So because the curtain is torn completely, it allows men to go into the most holy place without any with freedom.
Yeah, 本来的规定呢，只有一个大祭司一年一次才能够进去围着百姓来赎罪。
The previous regulation is that only allowing the high priest to go into this most holy place once a year.
现在幔子已经不在了。
But now the curtain is gone.
现在呢，每一个人，任何一个诚心信主的人，都能够进入到幔子之内，至圣所的里头。
So now any believer, faithful believer, can enter into the most holy of holies.
Yeah, 这幔子本来是一个障碍。
Previously, this curtain, works as a barrier.
但是现在撕裂了。
But now it is split apart.
是神撕裂了这幔子。
God torn it, tore it.
因着耶稣基督为我们舍命。
And it is torn because Jesus has sacrificed his life for us.
所以这个幔子已经挪开了。
And this curtain is cast away.
这个障碍是挪开了。
And so the barrier is gone.
那另外一个障碍呢，是罪的障碍。
And the other barrier.We talk about a sin.
在以赛亚书五十九章第二节所讲的，你们的罪孽使你们与神隔绝，你们的罪恶使他掩面不听你们。
So in Isaiah 59 verse 2 it says, But your iniquities have separated you from your God. Your sins have hidden his face from you so that he will not hear.
幔子的障碍挪开了。
So the barrier of the curtain has been taken away.
因着耶稣基督他赦罪的血，我们的罪孽的障碍也挪开了。
through the sacrificial blood of Jesus, our sins has also been cast away.
是因着耶稣的血，使我们能够坦然地进入到至圣所。
It is because of the blood of Jesus that we can walk into the holy of holies.
希伯来书第十章第二十二节更说到，我们心中天良的亏欠已经洒去，身体用清水已经洗净了。
So in verse 22, it also talks about how our hearts have been sprinkled to cleanse us of our guilty conscience.
Yeah, 所以我们的灵里面，我们的罪因着耶稣的宝血已经赦免。
In our soul, our sins has been forgiven by Jesus through His blood.
二十二节说，心中天良的亏欠也已经洒去了。
In verse 22, it says that our guilty conscience has also been sprinkled and cleansed.
身体的污秽也用清水洗净了。
And whatever sins that we have in our body has been cleansed.
灵里、心中、身体的污秽全然、全然的洗净。
So the sins and the iniquities in our heart and in our souls are all cleansed.
幔子的障碍已经挪开了。
The barrier caused by the curtain has been cast away.
罪的障碍已经挪开了。
The barrier caused by our sins has been cast away.
我们的大祭司耶稣基督，他在向我们说，欢迎。
Our great priest Jesus Christ is telling us, welcome.
他在告诉我们说，天父爱你。
He's telling us that Heavenly Father loves you.
他说天父接纳你。
That the Father accepts you.
天父赦免你。
And He forgives you.
他说来亲近我吧。
He's saying, come, draw closer to me.
主耶稣基督他为你为我来到世上。
Jesus come to earth because of you and me.
耶稣基督他在十字架上钉死是为了你，为了我。
Jesus was crucified on the cross because of you and me.
耶稣为了我们，他复活。
And Jesus, because of us, he's resurrected.
为了我们，他升天了。
And because of us, he's risen to heaven.
这一切呢，使他完成了，开了这条又新又活的路。
And all these help goes into opening this new and living way for us.
是一条新的路。
It is a new way.
是一个生命之道。
It is a path of life.
这条道路呢是不讲距离。
This way does not talk about distance.
而是讲亲近。
It's talking about drawing close.
是讲亲近神。
It's talking about drawing closer to God.
也讲亲近神的百姓。
And to draw close to the people of God.
那这条道路呢所讲的绝对不是树立障碍。
This way is not talking about establishing barriers.
因为幔子已经挪开了。
Because the curtain has been torn.
呀，他这条道路所讲的是一个通道，是一个往父那里去的通道。
This way is talking about a channel that leads us to God.
所以耶稣基督说，我就是道路，是真理，是生命。
That's why Jesus said He is the way, the truth, and the life.
呀，那我们在这条又新又活的路，我们要怎么走在上面呢？
So how are we going to walk on this new and living way?
这个不单单只是一个圣经的一个观念而已。
This is not a concept from the Bible.
但圣经的每一个神学或者每一个真理呢，都教导我们怎么活出来的。
Everything that the Bible teaches is teaching us how to live out this new and living way.
那所以呢，第二十三节就告诉我们第一个我们可以做的事情。
So in verse 23, you will see the very first thing that we all can do.
那第二十三节说你当存，对不起，在第二十二节那边说当存诚心和充足的信心来到神面前。
So in verse 22, actually, it says that let us draw near to God with a sincere heart and with full assurance of faith.
英语的圣经很清楚说 let us draw near.
It's very clear when the verse saying that let us draw near to God.
中文我们要强调的就是当来到神面前。
But in the Chinese version, it actually says when we come to the presence of God.
Yeah, 我们就是要来亲近神。
We want to draw close to God.
在这条道路，我们要怎么样走呢？就要来一个亲近神的方式来走。
So how do we walk this way? The way is to draw close to God.
马太福音第十一章二十八节。
In Matthew 11 verse 28,
凡劳苦担重担的人可以到我这里来，我就使你们得安息。
Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest.
那耶稣告诉我们说，我们可以到他那里去。
Jesus is telling us that we can come near to him.
马太福音十二章二十节，压伤的芦苇它不折断，将残的灯火它不吹灭。
So in Matthew 12 verse 20 it says, A bruised reed he will not break, a smoldering wick he will not snuff out.
这是耶稣基督的心态。
This is the attitude of his heart.
这是神对我们的那种心态跟眼光。
This is how God looks at us and wants to treat us.
凡劳苦担重担的可以来到我这里。
He's saying that all who are weary and burdened, come to me.
所以我们要学习亲近神。
So we must learn how to draw close to God.
我们要学习怎么样更多的来到神的面前。
We must learn how that we can come to God.
那就像玛利亚。
Just remember like Mary.
那玛利亚、马大的 这对姐妹呢？就当耶稣去到他家的时候，马大忙着一直在煮饭啊、煮菜啊，就是要好好的来接待耶稣。
So remember the story of Mary and Martha. When Jesus came to their house, with the sister Martha was busy in the kitchen preparing the meal and getting ready to serve Jesus.
但是玛利亚呢，她不做那些家务事，她就是坐在耶稣的身边听耶稣讲话。
But Mary, instead of doing all this housework and tidying it, he actually was sitting at the feet of Jesus, listening to Jesus.
当时呢，马大看到他受不了，马大还投诉了一下，说：“耶稣，耶稣，为什么你不叫玛利亚来帮我做一些家务呢？”
When Martha saw her sister just sitting at Jesus' feet, she was like not very happy. So she says, "Jesus, why don't you tell Mary to come and help me with all these things?"
但是耶稣反而跟马大说呢，玛利亚所选择的是上好的福分。
But Jesus told Martha that Mary has made the right choice.
Yeah, 我们有没有珍惜这些靠近耶稣、亲近耶稣的时候呢？
Do we treasure these moments where we can draw close to Jesus?
Yeah, 现在我们因为在很多时候在家哈，好像很多时候都是在看手机、看电脑。
Now that we are at home most of the time, I think we spend a lot of time looking at the computer or at our handphones.
哎呀，可能你说，哎呀，因为牧师每个早上都发一个灵修信息给我嘛。
Maybe you're saying that, oh, pastor always send these Nisi Bible scriptures to us every morning.
呀，然后呢，教会呢，礼拜一、礼拜三、礼拜五跟礼拜天都有一些就是手机的一些互动吧。
And there are also like things that is posted on our handphone on Mondays, on Wednesdays, on Fridays about scriptures and everything.
所以我可不可以奉劝大家，我们不要单单用手机来灵修，好不好？
I want to urge everybody that we don't just meditate using our handphone.
Yeah, 我们应该学习怎么样安静在神的面前，等候他，敬拜他。
We must learn how to be still.Still in the presence of God to worship Him and to honor Him.
Yeah, 我们要来祷告，并且要寻求他的心意。
We must pray and to seek His will.
我们要来聆听他的话语，并且学习怎么样顺服他的话。
We must learn how to listen to His words and to obey.
就像玛利亚她所选择的。
Just like what Mary has chosen to do.
静静地坐在耶稣的身边。听耶稣讲话。
She sat beside Jesus quietly and listened to Jesus speak.
然后我们也很熟悉的葡萄树跟枝子的比喻。
We also are very familiar with these grapes and the vines.
那约翰福音十五章第四到第七的第四到第七节，你们要藏在我里面，我也藏在你们里面。枝子若不藏在葡萄树，自己就不能结果子。你们若不藏在我里面，也是这样。第五节，我是葡萄树，你们是枝子，藏在我里面的，我也藏在他里面，这人就多结果子，因为离了我，你们就不能做什么。
So in John chapter 15 verses 4 to 5, remain in me as I also remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing.
我是葡萄树，你们是枝子。藏在我里面的，我也藏在你里面。
I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you.
呀，我们真的要学习怎么样常常跟葡萄树是接上的，让我们的生命跟主的生命是连接上的。
We must always remember and practice how to connect to Jesus like the vine and the branches. And we have to always stay connected to Jesus.
好，所以又新又活的路，第一件事呢，是要来亲近神。
So the first thing in living the new and living way is to draw close to God.
第二呢，就是要坚守或者守住，抓紧我们所承认的指望，不致摇动。
So the other thing is to hold fast onto our hopes and the will of God for us and not be steadfast.
是的，我们要抓紧。
We have to hang on tight.
呀，不动摇的。
And we cannot be wavering.
因为耶稣基督他是昨日、今日一直到永远，他是一样的。
Because Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
耶稣基督他是那位创始成终的神。
Jesus is the beginning and the end.
圣经告诉我们，耶稣基督他是阿拉法，他是俄梅伽。
And the Bible tells us that Jesus is the Alpha and the Omega.
耶稣基督，他是那位在十字架上说成了的那一位。
He is the person who was on the cross saying that it is finished.
他也是那个天使看着他升天，然后向着众人说：“你怎么看他上升？他也要驾着云彩再次下来。”
So he is also the one that ascended to heaven, as the angels were saying that the way he gone to heaven, same through the clouds, he's going to come back to earth.
是，他就是那位信实的神。
He is the faithful God.
呀，他是他的信实，叫我们能够信靠他，而且坚守着这个指望。
His faithfulness teach us how to trust him and to hang on to hopefully to him.
呀，所以呢，哥林多后书一章二十节说，神的应许不论有多少，在基督都是是的，所以借着他都是实在。阿门，叫神因我们得荣耀。
So in 2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 20, for no matter how many promises God has made, they are yes in Christ. And so through him, the Amen is spoken by us to the glory of God.
Yeah, 在基督里都是是的，都是 Amen 的。
Yes, in Christ, Amen in Christ.
那在生命记第七章九节更是说到他的信实，所以你要知道耶和华你的神，他是神，是信实的神，像爱他、守他诫命的人，守约、施慈爱，直到千代。
So in Deuteronomy chapter 7 verse 9, know therefore that the Lord your God is God. He's the faithful God.Keeping his covenant of love to 1,000 generations of those who love him and keep his commandments.
Yeah, 他是信实的神，他向爱他守诫命的人守约，并且施慈爱直到千代。
So he's the faithful God, keeping his covenant of love to 1,000 generations.
Yeah, 他守约，他会守住他跟我们的约定。
He will hang on to the covenant that he has with us.
Yeah, 他跟我们的约定的是，他爱我们就爱我们到底。
He will hang on to this covenant he has with us, and he will love us through the generations.
Now, 耶稣基督他代替了我们的软弱，担当了我们的疾病。
Jesus has taken over our weaknesses and taken over our sickness.
是我们在世上的日子有一些不好过的时候。
Of course, when we're living on earth, there are times when it's difficult for us.
我们有生病的时候。
There are times when we fall sick.
我们有忧伤的时候。
And there are times when we feel sad.
我们有孤单的时候。
And there are lonely moments.
我们有觉得很不容易应付的一些挑战。
And there are a lot of challenges that we cannot handle.
但是我们也都知道，这一切都是暂时的。
But we must remember that all these are temporary.
这些都会过去的。
These are transient, they will pass.
但是我们的神，他 他是永恒不改变的。
But our God, He is everlasting, never changing.
他是信实的。
He is faithful.
他向着我们是守约并且施慈爱的。
He is the one that will keep His covenant and will continue to love us.
所以呢，我们就可以坚守着这个指望。
So we can keep His commandments.
我们知道呢，他既然已经升天，他也要再来。
We know that He has ascended to heaven and He will come again.
我们知道呢，他是昨日、今日，直到永远都不改变的。
And we know that He's the same yesterday, today, and forever.
要尝试一下，试想一下，神过去所给我们的恩典或者祝福。
Think about all the blessings and all the grace that God has given to us.
其实很多很多的，我们要就像一首诗歌所讲的，主的恩典样样都要数。
So remember the praise and worship song where we talk about how we count the blessings of God.
真的好多好多神的恩典，我们要一直能够数算的。
We have endless blessings from Him, and we have to count them.
那我讲到这里的时候，我就想到呢。二月底到三月十一号，我跟师母我们去了纽西兰，度过了我们三十周年的结婚周年纪念。
When I talk about this, I recall how Simu and myself we went to celebrate our wedding anniversary in end of February to early March.
Yeah, 你懂，在那个时候呢，这个新冠病毒疫情已经开始了。
At that time, this COVID-19 crisis has started.
但是神给我们，我跟师母有一段最美好、最美好的结婚周年纪念的旅游。
But God gave us the most memorable anniversary trip.
呀，没人可以想到，怎么我们回国之后的一两个星期呢？每一个国家就开始关闭了，封闭了，没办法出门了。
We would have never have guessed that after we have returned to Singapore, so many countries started closing their countries, their entries.
Yeah, 神的恩典
God's grace.
样样都要数
And it's just we have to keep counting His blessings.
好不好？等一下呢，你就打一个电话，然后呢，跟你教会跟你小组的弟兄姐妹讲一讲。你刚刚感恩的一些事情，跟他讲说，神的恩典是那么的多。
So how about after service, call up one of your Connect Group members and tell them how the blessings and count the blessings to them and see what he has been blessed with all this time.
Yeah, 所以我们讲到要坚守这个我们所承认的指望。
So we talk about how we must hang on to His covenant for us.
我总觉得呢，我要向我们当中的长辈们讲几句话。
I feel like I should speak to the elderly members in our church.
主耶稣在我心。
Jesus knows my heart.
安慰我，给我生命。
Comfort me and give me life.
赐我平安，赐我喜乐。
Give me joy and give me peace.
行过风雨路。
Whether I go through storms or rain.
伊的明白，伊拢了解。
He understands.
擦去我的目屎。
He will wipe away my tears.
对我真实在。
And he's so steadfast. The wind might blow, but the wind will never knock me down. Hold me, love me, and always protecting me.
你是我的信心，是我的帮助。
You are my trust, my confidence, and you are my help.
坚强我的心灵，耶稣真正好。
Strengthen my spirit and my soul. Jesus is so good.
这首歌是我们长辈们很喜欢唱的一首歌。
This is a song that our elderly members love.
Yeah, 今天我就不献丑不唱了。
Today I shall not sing.
Yeah, 希望你们在家里面呢，你们可以游啊，风雨吹不倒了。
Please go ahead and sing about how the wind and storm will not knock me down.
Yeah, 我们会把歌词发给你们啦。
I will send the lyrics of the song to you.
Okay, 好，所以记得。信靠我们的神，坚定的信心，然后呢，数算他的恩典，帮助我们能够在困难的日子带着信心来信靠他。
So let's continue to hang on to God's commandment. Believe in this love that is giving us that we can count our blessings every day of our life.
好，这个又新又活的路，第一件事情是来亲近神，第二件事情是坚定我们的指望，第三呢，就是要彼此相顾，激发爱心，勉励行善。
So the new and living way first is to is to draw close to God. And secondly, is to hang on to His covenant of love. And thirdly, is to spur each other on towards love and good deeds.
Yeah, 那中文圣经讲得很清楚，彼此相顾，激发爱心跟勉励行善。英语开始他说 ，Let us consider.
So in the English verse, it says that let us consider how we must spur each other.
这个 consider 它有一个意思是 pay attention, 是留心注意。
When we use the word consider here, when it was used here, it means that you have to pay attention.
Yeah, 我们到底要留心注意什么
？What are we paying attention to?
留心注意我的头发有没有乱吗？
To pay attention to our hair.
留心注意我今天要吃什么东西吗
？Or to pay attention to what I'm going to have for lunch.
这里所讲的，你要留心注意你的弟兄姐妹们。
No, here is talking about how we must pay attention to our brothers and sisters.
那所以中文圣经一翻就翻成要彼此相顾，其实呢就是说，我们其实要注意，我们要怎么样去相顾、照顾我们的弟兄姐妹们。
Very clearly, this verse is telling us that we must pay attention to how we can look after and care for our brothers and sisters.
不单单只是要专心注意，而且要 spur one another, 就是要激发，要勉励。
So not only are we paying attention to their needs, but we also want to urge each other on and make each other towards this.
Yeah, 所以这个呢，原文的意思呢，有一点就是你要推推，你要催催，你要唠叨唠叨。
So we use the word spur, you give a connotation that we have to like push or nag or just provoke.
Yeah, 就是真的，这里圣经其实它的意思是呢，我们不单只是要留心的注意周围的需要，而且我们要不断的提醒一下，哎，做一做这个东西，哎，做一做这个东西，这个就是我们要催、要去推、要去唠叨的事。
So not only must we look out for things that are needed to be cared for or people that needs to be cared for, but we have to remember that we have to like remind each other and encourage each other to go do these things for them.
那我给你一个例子，是在路加福音第五章，那四个朋友把一位瘫痪的朋友呢带到耶稣的面前的故事。
So there's this parable about how these four friends had to bring a paralyzed man to Jesus.
Yeah, 我想当时呢，他们可能四个人当中呢，有三个在那边说：“哎呀，不用这样麻烦啦。”
I believe that among the four friends, maybe three of them were going like, why take all this trouble?
看耶稣在那边教导，那个房间已经爆满了，没机会进去的。
Look, the place where Jesus was teaching is so crowded. There's no way we can go in.
哎呀，没有关系啦，反正他已经瘫痪那么久了，就给他继续躺在那边啦。
And some might be saying, oh, you know, he's already been paralyzed for so long. Let's just carry on with his life.
我们就照常每天为他按手祷告就可以了。
Let's continue to just lay hand and pray for him.
Yeah.或者我们等一等啦，可能耶稣等一下从那边出来，他会走经过我们这里也不一定吗
？Or we can just like wait around, and when Jesus comes out from the crowd, then he might just pass us.
哦，所以这三个人都是有很多的借口，总是不用了，不用了，最好是什么都不用做了。
So all these three friends must have lots of excuses. In now it's all right, we don't have to do anything.
但是其中的一个，他懂得怎么样留心注意。
But among them, there's one that said that he is actually looking out for ways.
而且呢，他也懂得怎么样激发勉励。
And he knows how to spur them on.
他说：“不行，不行，不行，我们一定要去。”
He says, "No, no, we must go."
耶稣来到我们这个城镇，他这个是很难得、很宝贵的时候。
For Jesus to come to our town is so precious. The time that he is here.
我要赶快去找一个路子，可以把这个朋友带到那里去。
I want to look for a donkey to bring this friend there.
而且我看我们现在呢，想办法呢，就是找梯子呢，把这个路子带上去的 mat 可以带上去，然后呢，从屋顶可以把它。 这个坠下去。
And we'll place this friend on the mat, and then we will bring it up to the roof of the room and lower the body to the room.
而且呢，我会想办法呢，测量一下到底耶稣在什么地方，叫我们可以准准的把人带放到耶稣的面前来。
So then I'm going to like find out where Jesus exactly is standing or sitting, and I'll make that opening so that we can lower this friend straight in front of Jesus.
然后他会不停的说：“赶快，赶快，赶快！你做这个，你做这个，你做这个，我们一起的抬这个朋友过去吧。”
You can imagine that he was giving instructions, telling his friends what to do, so that they can bring this mat and this paralyzed man to Jesus.
这个叫做彼此相顾，激发爱心，勉励行善。
This is called we call spurring each other on to good deeds.
结果这个瘫子呢，他在耶稣面前，耶稣赦免了他的罪，并且呢医治了他。他拿着褥子，然后给荣耀给神，就离开了这个房子。
So what happened in the end? This man was healed by Jesus. He picked up his mat and he walked out after he was healed.
我们需要做这样的事。
We have to do things like that.
我们不单只是要留意周围有什么需要。
Not only do we have to look out for the needs of people around us,
而且我们一定要不停地激发朋友，激发弟兄姐妹做善事，做应该做的事情。
But we must continue to spur our brothers and sisters, spur each other on to love and doing good deeds.
那我们在家中呢，师母是做这件事做得最好的。
In my family, 师母 is the best person. She's always doing this.
她常常提醒我们两个孩子呢，赶快去。做这个事情，做耶稣要你做的事，赶快去做。
She's always reminding us and spurring us on to say, "Go, do this, because Jesus would want you to do these things."
你知道吗？有一些失落、失望的人在我们的周围。
We know that there are those who are lost and hopeless amongst us.
你知道吗？在我们的周围，有人已经想要放弃了。
And there are people around us who is about to give up.
那你知道吗？你周遭的人里头已经有人说，没有人关心我，没有人了解我。
And among us, there'll be people who say that nobody understands me, nobody cares for me.
哎呀，一定有人需要你的关心。
There will be somebody that you need to care for.
可能有一天你需要人的关心。
Maybe you are the one that needs someone to care for.
那一定有人需要你的安慰。
There will be someone that needs comfort.
或者有一天你是需要被安慰的人。
Or maybe you will be the one that's in need of the comforting.
有人肯定需要你的鼓励。
There will be somebody needing encouragement.
所以呢，我们好不好打开我们的眼睛，留意周围的需要。
Let us open our eyes and look around for the needs of others.
现在呢，也要打开我们的耳朵，多在电话上面联系的时候，感受一下别人的心酸。
So now is the time to pick up the phone and speak to our brothers and sisters to hear their needs, to hear those who need help.
耶稣基督给我们的新命令，一条新命令，乃是叫你们彼此相爱。我怎么爱你们，你们也要怎么相爱。
Jesus gave us a new commandment, and he says that love one another as I have loved you, so you must love one another.
那保罗在加拉太书六章二节也告诉我们，你们个人的重担要互相担当。
Paul also wrote this in Galatians that we should carry each other's burden.
所以这条又新又活的路。
So this new and living way,
不是单靠着照顾自己。
It's not about just taking care of yourself.
也肯定不是自我隔离。
And it's not about distancing yourself from others.
自我封闭。
And to form a barrier between you and other people.
而是呢，我们要出去去照顾，去爱护。
But for us to step out there and care for others and to do things for others.
所以我们要主动的。
We have to be motivated.
然后现在教会没有办法就是让大家一起聚集，我们更加要主动的去彼此关心。
Now the church can't make everybody, we can't come to church as one body. So now you have to be self-motivated, go out there and help others.
呀，多一些去留意我们弟兄姐妹的需要。
Continue to look out for the needs of your brothers and sisters.
好，第四个，在又新又活的路，我们可以做的是什么？
So what's the fourth thing that we can do to living this new and living way?
第二十五节说，你们不可停止聚会。
In verse 25, it says, "Let us not give up meeting together."
啊，我们现在是不准聚会啊。
But unfortunately, now we are not allowed to meet.
我们肯定不是不想聚会。
It's not because we don't want to.
我们现在呢，珍惜能够 online 聚会的时间呢。
We treasure the time that we can meet each other online.
那但是呢，在网上聚会呢，还是好像少了很少了什么这样的。
But meeting each other online is like something is missing, right?
Yeah, 我们在这个主日聚会没有那一个真正的现场的敬拜的气氛。
We don't feel that ambiance when we come together to praise and worship in church.
那我们在现在呢，真的感受到没有聚会实在是一个很大的、很大的欠缺啊。
So now we all feel this big part missing in us when we can't come together to worship like this.
因为当我们一起聚会的时候，我们可以用一个整体的方式来侍奉神。
So when we can come together, we can serve God as one body.
我们在聚会的时候呢，因为跟彼此的接触，我们还可以彼此的服侍。
So when we come together, we can also serve and minister to each other.
因为我们接触呢，我们就可以直接的做到彼此相顾，而且还可以勉励行善。
So when we come together, we can actually take care of each other and spur one another on.
所以聚会的时候呢，就让我们可以做第三点，做得很容，就很轻易的做到了。
So when we meet together, we can easily do the third thing.
好，现在这一件事我们暂时不能做。
But at the moment, we can't do it.
希望教会开放之后呢，我们一起赶快冲回来教会吧。
I hope that when the church reopens fully, we'll all rush back to church.
Yeah, 现在我们允许个人回到教会有一段个人默祷的时间哦。
Now we can allow people coming to church for their own private prayer.
Yeah, 如果你真的有需要这样的一段时候的话，打电话到我们教会办公室，我们可以跟你预约，让你回到教会能够有一段时间来亲近神。
If you feel this need that you need to come into the sanctuary for a private prayer, make an appointment, call the church office, and we will arrange the time for you to come in.
好，有一个经文我要跟大家分享，最后一个经文是在《帖撒罗尼迦后书》第二章第一节。
So the last scripture I want to share with you all is in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 1.
论到我们主耶稣基督降临和我们到他那里聚集。
Concerning the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and our being gathered to him.
这边这个聚集跟希伯来书第十章第二十五节的聚会同样的一个原文的字。
So the word gathered here in 2 Thessalonians is similar to the one in Hebrew about meeting together.
所以希伯来书所讲的是在教会的聚会。
In Hebrews, it's talking about meeting in church.
在帖撒罗尼迦后书所讲的是在基督那里，主再来的时候在天上的聚会。
In Thessalonians, 2 Thessalonians is talking about gathering in heaven with Jesus.
我要给大家看到一个我们在永恒的一个荣耀的盼望。
I want to remind you all of this eternal glory time that we have.
我们不单只是在今生在教会的聚集，我们以后在永恒的里面，我们还有一个聚集的时候。
Not only do we meet here.In this present life, but we have this everlasting time. No, this meeting in our everlasting home in heaven.
又新又活的路
the new and living way.
我们要一起走在当中
Let us all walk together.
我们要更多的来以敬拜、以祷告来亲近神
We have to continue to worship and to draw close to God.
我们抓紧、坚定、坚守着这个在基督里面的指望。
We have to hang on and steadfastly onto this covenant in Christ.
无论我们有的聚会或者没的聚会，我们都要彼此相顾，并且鼓励一起的去做行善跟讨主喜悦的每一件事。
So whether we meet in person or not, we must continue to look out for care needs of others and spur one another on to do things of love and of good deeds.
这就是神所说的又新又活的路。
This is what God meant by a new and living way.
我们一起来祷告。
Let us all pray.
让我们都举起双手。
Let us raise our hands.
在祷告的时候，我也要为这任何病痛软弱者来祷告。我们举起手来，我们也同时的领受医治。
Let us pray, lifting our needs and our healing unto Jesus.
天父上帝，我们满心的感谢你。
Jesus, we thank you.
感谢主，你以你的话语向我们说话。
Lord, we thank you that you are speaking with us.
今天我们的心灵敞开，领受你的话语。
Lord, we open our hearts and receive your words.
我们宣告。今天你 所发出的每一句话都在每一个人的心田里面成为美好的种子。
We declare that all the words that were spoken today will bear good fruits and plant seeds into the hearts of people.
奉耶稣基督的名，每一个人的心中要涌出那种对神的渴慕。
In Jesus' name, the yearning will come out from every heart.
奉耶稣基督的名，每一颗信心都要坚定在你的里头。
In Jesus' name, all hearts will be steadfast in Christ.
奉主耶稣基督的名，每一个信徒有更多的爱心，能够出去彼此的相顾。
In Jesus' name, every believer will go in the name of Christ to love one another.
奉耶稣基督的名，我们举起双手，我们要领受医治。
In Jesus' name, as we lift up our hands, we will receive healing.
各样的病痛
，all illnesses.
主你都知道。
Lord, you know.
耶稣基督，你代替了我们的软弱。
Jesus, you've taken over our weaknesses.
你担当了我们的疾病。
Lord, you have taken upon yourself our illnesses.
奉耶稣基督的名，领受主的医治。
In Jesus' name, we receive your healing.
耶稣基督的宝血赦免我们一切的罪孽。
The blood of Jesus forgive all our sins.
耶稣基督所受的鞭伤使我们得到一切的医治。
And through his stripes, we are all healed.
今天我们坦然无惧地进入到至圣所。
Fearlessly, we enter the throne of grace.
来到神的面前，来向神来祈求主你的怜悯，你的恩典。
We come before God to ask for your mercy.
主啊，你来医治我们。
Lord, heal us.
我们有各样的需要，我们也求主你来供应我们。
Whatever needs that we have, we want, Lord, you will provide.
我也奉耶稣基督的名，要祝福各个家庭平安。
In Jesus' name, we also bless every family.
奉耶稣基督的名，我要祝福各个家庭有神的供应。
In the name of Jesus, we also bless every family that God will provide what they need.
奉耶稣基督的名，祷告主啊，你使到每一个人信心满满的来信靠你。
In the name of Jesus, I pray that all will come to you filled with faith.
所以愿主耶稣基督的恩惠。May the Lord, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, 愿天父的慈爱 and the love of the Father, and 愿圣灵的感动 and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, 与我们众人同在。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.心底。